making headlines tonight. Forward we go under Skerritt and Shallow. Man City extend lead atop Premier League. And former middleweight champ passes away. Good evening and welcome to the major ZBK Sports Edition for Monday, March 15, 2021. I am your presenter, Terry Laraji. Now for the details. We begin tonight bowling off with cricket. Forward we go. That is the mantra, staying on track with the cricket first policy Ricky Skerritt and Kishore Shallow are running with as they seek a second term in office at the helm of Cricket West Indies. Speaking on today's Sportsline show, President Skerritt explained that putting the right people in the right positions was of utmost importance for his administration, especially none other than CWI Director of Cricket, Jimmy Adams.
There were too many people obstructing Jimmy Adams from what he had to do. Jimmy knows what he needs to do. He needs help in some areas. He may need a little fortification in some areas. He may need a little sustenance in some areas. But you need to know when to get out of the way and leave Jimmy to work. In fact, one of my biggest roles in the less than 2 years that I've been president has been to protect people like Jimmy and the CEO and others from unnecessary and untimely interference from members of the board and others. We have to understand that they're those who are paid to carry out significant responsibilities, and we need to allow them to do that, and we need to help them to do that by giving them the best tools and resources available.
CWI President Ricky Skerritt. WI means West Indies Cricket and the Skerritt-Shallow leadership. Forward means Skerritt-Shallow is upgrading the Cricket First platform already established in their first term with many successful outcomes already achieved. And go means achieving momentum on all fronts. Meanwhile, the West Indies completed a clean sweep of Sri Lanka in the three-match one-day international series yesterday at the Sir Vivian Richards Cricket Stadium, winning the final match by 5 wickets. After being sent in, Sri Lanka mustered up a competitive 274 in their 50 overs, thanks to an unbeaten 7th-wicket partnership of 123 from Hasaranga and Bandara that lifted them out of trouble, as at one stage they looked like being bowled out before their allotted overs when they had slumped to 151 for 6 in the 32nd. In reply, the Windies always had things under control, with another half-century from player of the series Shea Hope and Darren Bravo, who brought up his 4th one-day international century, passing his 3,000th one-day international career runs in the process, the home side getting home with 9 balls to spare. The left-handed Bravo, in his 111th innings, made 102 off 132 balls with 4 sixes and 5 fours. The 3 wins in this series earned the West Indies 30 points and moved them up to 5th position in the International Cricket Council's Super League table. It was also the 3rd consecutive series win for West Indies, following the sensational 2-0 Test series result in Bangladesh last month and the 2-1 win in the CG Insurance T20 International Series at the Coolidge Cricket Ground last week. Scores in the match, West Indies 276 for 5, or 48.3 overs, Bravo 102, Hope 64, Pollard 53 not out, Lakmal 2 for 56, Sri Lanka 274 for 6, Hasaranga 80 not out, Bandara 55 not out, Hussain 3 for 33. Speaking after the series, a joyous Windy skipper Kyron Pollard was pleased with a real team effort.
These guys have been working, you know, really, really hard in a competition, you know, for places, you know, as well. And, you know, guys want to stick their neck up. You know, we spoke about, you know, one guy, you know, batting through the order, batting deep as possible. And, you know, it's very nice to see each and every, you know, game we got 100, you know, Hopi in the first game, Evan in the second, and now Brav, you know, in this one. So that means, you know, the guys are really focused on, you know, what they want to do and what they want to achieve. And, you know, just for the back end to try to finish it off. So again, it's just total team effort, you know, from us. The guys, you know, bowl well. I came out and, you know, we really play as a team, you know, when the bowlers falter, the batters take up the mantle.
Kyron Pollard. On Friday, Evan Lewis scored his 4th one-day international century to help lay the platform for the West Indies 5-wicket victory over Sri Lanka with 2 balls to spare. Speaking later to the media, Lewis said that he enjoys batting with Shea Hope and believes in them as opening partners.
We can play plenty drop and run, you know, with the left and right hand combination. You know, I feed off him sometimes, and he feed off me sometimes. So I think batting with him is excellent. You know, he's a guy always have confidence. You know, I feel very at ease when I bat at him. You know, we both feed off each other's energy. Batting with him has been good so far. We're just looking to continue.
Lewis himself also has ambitions of one day playing Test cricket.
Actually, I've gotten that question from many people. It's actually something I've think about. The only problem is that I haven't played 40 cricket in a while now. I'm not sure if the 40 cricket is going to play this year. It's something I've been thinking about, like, seriously. I'm giving it a good thought. You know, at the end of the day, test cricket is the ultimate. Everyone wants to play test cricket. And once I play a couple of 40 games and probably do well, I would like to be also accounted to be on the test team.
Evan Lewis, man of the match in the second one-day international. Lewis scored 103 and shared in a record 192-run first-wicket partnership with Shea Hope, who made 84, as the West Indies took an unassailable 2-0 lead in the three-match series. It was the best-ever first-wicket stand at the Sir Vivian Richards Cricket Stadium. And with attention now turning to the two-match test series against Sri Lanka, West Indies' new test captain Craig Brathwaite says with a similar squad that he led to the 2-0 series victory in Bangladesh, he personally will keep leading from the front.
For me, you know, I continue to lead from the front and in attitude, you know, in preparation. And, you know, I had a chat with none of these guys, I mean, even from Bangladesh. And it's not gonna change. You know, the key is not to slacken off. We have two matches, so, you know, it's 10 days of cricket. So, you know, we have to do. And for me, it's all about attitude. And that's from attitude, from warming up, to if it's doing a little feeling, you know, simple things. I think once we commit, the right mindset, the right attitude to these things, it will take care of performance. So, you know, for me, I will lead by example. You know, we have a number of senior guys in the team to lead as well. So, you know, and I don't see it changing. I think we're in good hands. We're in good hands going forward as a team. You know, I think that same mindset will take us very far.
Craig Brathwaite. The first test against Sri Lanka bowls off on March 21. Meantime, carrying what was effectively a three-man attack of otherwise modest penetration, Rashid Khan bowled 99.2 overs across back-to-back Zimbabwe innings and picked up 11 wickets to lead Afghanistan to a 6-wicket victory, their third win in 6 test matches that levelled the two-match series at 1-all yesterday. Scores Afghanistan 545 for 4 declared, Shahidi 200 not out, Afghan 164 and 108 for 4, Rahmat 58, beat Zimbabwe 287, Rashid 4 for 138, and 365, Williams, 151 not out, Tirupano, 95, Rashid, 7 for 137. Meanwhile, India responded to their crushing defeat in Friday's opening T20 International by turning the tables on England yesterday. Ishan Kishan enjoyed a stellar India debut as his brilliant 56 helped Virat Kohli's side to a 7-wicket win to level the 5-match series at 1-all. Scores India 166 for 3 off 17.5 overs, Kohli 73 not out, Kishan 56, England 164 for 6, Roy 46, Sundar 2 for 29. And the Ahmedabad pitch, on which India beat England in 2 days in the third test, will not be punished by the International Cricket Council, ICC. The pitch has been given an average rating by match referee Jawagal Srinath, meaning it will not earn any demerit points. An accumulation of demerit points can lead to venues being suspended from hosting international matches. In other sporting developments tonight, running into athletics, Oregon's Kemba Nelson ran a collegiate leading 7.05 seconds to win the 60-meter title on the final day of the 2021 NCAA Division I Nationals on Saturday night. In a final where there were three Caribbean nations, Jamaica, Antigua and Barbuda, and Grenada were represented, Nelson stormed a victory, pulling away from the stacked field to produce a massive personal best that is both a meet and championship record. Antigua's own Joella Lloyd, who 2 weeks ago set a new national record of 7.15, was sixth in 7.23. Nelson became the first Jamaican-born female athlete to attend the University of Oregon, having expressed a desire to compete in NCAA-level athletics. Kicking into football in the English Premier League over the weekend, Leeds and Chelsea played out a nil-all draw. Crystal Palace defeated West Brom 1-0. Burnley beat Everton 2-1. Sergio Aguero scored his first Premier League goal since January 2020, as Manchester City extended their lead at the top of the Premier League table with a 3-0 win at struggling Fulham. Brighton boosted their survival chances by defeating Southampton 2-1. Leicester thrashed Sheffield United 5-0. In the London Derby, Arsenal came from behind to beat Tottenham 2-1. and an own goal helped Man United. So after 30 games, Man City are now on 71, 14 points ahead of Man United, who are second on 57 with a game in hand. Leicester are third on 56 points, Chelsea fourth on 51. West Ham, who have played 28 games, are fifth on 48, and rounding off the top six is Everton on 46 points, also after 28 games. Meantime, Pelé congratulated Cristiano Ronaldo after the Portugal forward's hat-trick against Cagliari, took him past the Brazilian legend's tally of goals scored in official matches. Ronaldo netted three times inside the opening 32 minutes for Juventus to take his career total to 770, three clear of Pelé's tally of 767. Shooting into basketball in the NBA yesterday, Stephen Curry inspired the Warriors to victory over leaders, the Utah Jazz, on his 33rd birthday. Curry scored 32 points as the Warriors ended a four-game losing streak with a 131-119 win. The Thunder rolled the Grizzlies 128-122 as Alexander dropped in 30. The Heat beat the Magic 102-97. The Hawks downed the Cavaliers 100-82. The Celtics rocked the Rockets 134-107. The Timberwolves blazed the Trailblazers 114-112 as Edwards dropped in 34. The Bulls wrapped up the Raptors 118-95. And the Pelicans, they clipped the Clippers 135-115 as Williamson netted 27. Stepping into the boxing ring now, former undisputed middleweight world champion Marvelous Marvin Hagler has died at the age of 66. The American dominated the middleweight division from 1979 until his controversial defeat by Sugar Ray Leonard in April 1987. Hagler fought 67 times during his 14-year professional career, winning 62. He triumphed on 52 occasions by knockout, while he drew two and lost three times. Hagler made 12 successful title defenses until his defeat by Leonard by a split decision, and he retired a year later. Driving into motor racing, legendary Formula One commentator Murray Walker has also died at the age of 97. Walker commentated on his first Grand Prix for the BBC at Silverstone in 1949 and became a full-time Formula One commentator in 1978. He became synonymous with Formula One through his commentary, first with the BBC and then ITV before retiring in 2001. Swinging into golf, Justin Thomas emerged on a hectic final day to win the Players' Championship by one stroke as Lee Westwood finished runner-up for a second successive week. The world number three produced some sensational golf to post a 4-under-68 as he came from 3 back to win his 14th PGA Tour title on 14-under. Westwood led heading into Sunday's action at TPC Sawgrass but was pegged back after a wobble on the front nine. He finished one ahead of Bryson DeChambeau, who beat him last week. Serving into tennis, two-time Grand Slam champion Garbini Muguruza claimed a first WTA title in almost 2 years after winning the Dubai Championships. The 27-year-old Spaniard beat Czech Barbara Krajicekova 7-6-6-3 as she claimed her first title since victory in Monterrey in April 2019. Muguruza survived a set point against her opposition in the first set before going on to win. And finally tonight on this day in history in 1981, perhaps the greatest over in Test history. The 6 balls that Michael Holding bowled to Jeff Boycott in Bridgetown, Barbados, only the second over of England's innings, were absolutely chilling in their ferocity and pace. So much for looseness, each ball was quicker than the last, until the 6th swung in and sent Boycott's off stump flying. Chris Ohl was later described as having the look of a man who had seen a monster. And as the cliche goes, Boycott did well to get naught. And that story has brought us to the end of our sporting developments for tonight. Now to recap our top story. Forward we go. That is the mantra, staying on track with the Cricket First policy. President Ricky Skerritt and Vice President Dr. Kishore Shallow are running with as they seek a second term in office at the helm of Cricket West Indies. I have been your presenter, Terry Laraji. Thank you for listening. Stay tuned now for your Voice of America update to enjoy the rest of your evening. Rally, rally around the West Indies. One forever.